Hello, in this video I will show you how to install the latest stable GCC 9 on a Raspberry Pi computer and how to build C++ 17 programs with the new compiler. At the time of this recording, GCC 9 is the latest and greatest, while the default GCC from Raspbian is GCC 8. The advantage of using GCC 9 is that it has better error messages and better support for the latest C++ standard. As a side note, my recording equipment is Windows specific, so I am connected to my Raspberry Pi through SSH. You should be able to follow my steps directly on a Raspberry Pi that is connected to the internet. Just open a terminal and follow the tutorial. If you wish, you can read more about changes and improvements in the GCC 9 on the gcc.gnu.org webpage. Since there is no official GCC 9 binary for Raspbian, I've compiled it from sources and made it available in a Git repository for anyone to use. If you want to build it yourself, check the video description for a link to an article in which I describe the full procedure. In this video, I will show you how to install the already built GCC 9. As far as I know, this should work with Raspberry Pi 2 and up. Currently, I don't own a Raspberry Pi 4 to test it, but there is no reason for the compiler not to work. As mentioned before, I am logged in through SSH on my Raspberry Pi. Let's start by making sure that Raspbian is updated. Run the next command in a terminal. Sudo apt update, sudo apt upgrade, -y. Once the update is finished, we can start the installation. I will put all the commands used in the video description for your convenience. First, you will need to install Git, which can be done with sudo apt install git. Next, let's download my compiled version of GCC 9. Go inside the folder you just downloaded. Now we need to extract the archive. Use the next command. Once the extraction is finished, we need to move the GCC 9 folder to the -opt location on your Raspberry Pi. Go back one directory and optionally remove the downloaded repository in order to recover some space. Next, we need to add the new compiler to the system path and make a few symbolic links. Use the next command to print the version of the installed GCC compiler. This also checks if the previous steps were correctly executed. Please note that if you want to use GCC 9, you will need to specify the version number like in the above example. So, if you want to use the C++ compiler, you will use G++-9.1. Next, I will show you how to build a C++ 17 program. For simplicity, I am using the Nano text editor here. Feel free to use your preferred editor. This code will recursively print all files and folders from the current location. I will put a link to the code in the video description. The next command will compile the previously written C++ file using the C++ 17 standard and enable all warnings. If you run the generated executable, it will print a list with all files and folders from the current directory. Hope you learned something useful from this tutorial. If you want me to record more Raspberry Pi videos related to C or C++ development, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching and please like, share and subscribe.